Hello, guys, welcome to the International. I'm here with RTC, and we are going to just ask him the question that everybody in South America is asking me to say. We're very thankful for helping the South American teams qualify for international after the major performance. You are aware of the meme, Te queremos Arturito, right?
Yeah, it was just really random. After we played against Enigma,
yes,
I just... Everyone was talking about some meme, so yes. I went to my Twitter and I just saw like the same dog with a hat and the thing. Mm-hmm. Te quiero.
Yeah, te quiero mucho, Arturito.
Yeah, that word, those words, and then I was confused.
Yeah, I mean, actually, it's funny. This te quiero mucho, Arturito. Would you care to try saying this?
No, I'm really bad at language.
Yeah, don't
I'm
worry.
Really bad at
language. So basically, what means, if you don't know, is we love you very much, Arturito, and basically, and the whole story of the meme is actually one friend of mine. Was watching the game. I was very excited by the fact that, you know, you guys helped the South American teams qualify. Mm-hmm. They just posted on a random Facebook post and suddenly it blew up and everyone was posting it everywhere. And, you know, suddenly it was like the meme of death that month, right? So it was pretty funny. And people all around the community were asking me to, you know, bring you the shirts. Alas, we couldn't do that.
Yeah, when I saw it, I actually really wanted to get one myself. Like, yes. I wanted to buy one. It was so cute.
I will make this promise, however. If I find time myself, I will try to get you one of the shirts before the event ends.
So sounds hype. I would love it.
I wanted to bring one Alianza Lima shirt to Poppy, but that couldn't make it happen. You know the Alianza Lima meme. So basically, what we do is this team in Peru. This is called Alianza Lima. Uh-huh. And when you just give a shirt or give that symbol to a team, they usually lose. The team is like cursed. And for some reason, Secret is using that meme a lot recently. So I'll get you one shirt of Alianza Lima.
I don't want it.
So I wanted to ask you also about the South American teams. People will kill me if I don't ask you about, you know, the three South American teams we have. We have AC, we have Viscos, and we have Thunder in the event. And I don't know if you want to provide some, you know, statement about them. How do you think about them, or if you think they're going to perform this event?
We actually thought, SG and Thunder Predator, they have been both our one of like major scrimming partners,
yes,
like through the whole DPC, even in the beginning, the first season, and then the next season before the next major we played. We were really confused how they didn't, because they were actually very good in scrims, so I was surprised they didn't do well in the DPC circuit. But they managed to make it to TI anyway, so we always thought they're pretty good, and they're definitely a good scrim team. Like for us, we feel like they play really well and we can learn some things and they can learn from us and we just keep playing. Feels good. Thunder Predator is like super inconsistent, I think. Mm-hmm. It's like they have some times when they're like really good and then they have some times when they're really bad. Every team has it, but they're very, yes, like consistently like this, feels like. I'm not sure why, but they have a Fear coaching now, I think. So maybe he's going to bring them some stability. We only played them a few times in our boot camp, so they still look like one day against us, they're playing kind of like noobs, and then the next day they're playing well. So it's kind of like, I guess they go through a process.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of random, right? Like everybody was very surprised about Thunder performing at the first major outstandingly, and suddenly they just flopped the second DPC, and suddenly they don't even qualify for the major. So it's definitely interesting. And from your perspective, now you open this line of questioning. How do you think teams approach this kind of instability, right? Like, do you think there's a mindset you can have to try to avoid that, or there's the process of thought just to, you know, not happening? So that doesn't happen.
Well, I think usually having a coach can help you with this. It seems like they understood it too. They need somebody to, like, you don't want to always go up and down. You want to like kind of like,
yes,
you know. And I guess they felt like the coach was necessary. And I don't know what to do other than to kind of make sure everyone's on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
That's like the best thing you can do as a team that is very inconsistent. If you are consistent, you try to look at what makes you consistent. And if you're inconsistent, you look at what makes you inconsistent. You try to find the things that you can tweak.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you. My last question basically is going to be about South American style of play, right? Mm-hmm. Because when you play with against South American teams, it feels different, right? It feels like, you know, European teams maybe are more organized, mm-hmm. Chinese teams or Asian teams, for instance, have a little structure, right? And we have this thing where every region plays widely different.
Yeah.
So I would like if you could share your opinion about the South American style, how would you define them?
I actually think over the last like year, there's like there's like Thunder Predator and SG. I feel those two teams are kind of becoming more like international style, like in a sense. Like I think those teams are actually becoming way better as like they're trying to be more like a team, I feel. And Beast Coast, I don't see it the same way. Beast Coast is like Beast Coast is SA Dota in my mind, like the way they play, that's how I think they play SA. But then when I look at SG and Thunder Predator, I view them actually trying to become like similar to EG, LGD, like the last two majors, those teams, the top three teams, they're actually trying to become more like them. And I don't know if it's good for them or not, but they're definitely trying to get some structure. And when I look at Beast Coast, I think their structure is like very like bare minimum. I don't even know if they have a structure, like I can't tell, but they obviously do some things every game the same, but it's hard to know like how much they actually think of, yeah, we're gonna do this every game, or more they just do random shit. So
that's welcome to South America's time. So yeah, I think that's all for us. Just yeah, we appreciate your time and wish you the best on this tournament.
Thank you. I can't wait for that shirt to come.
If
you find it.
Yeah, I will try to get it for sure 100%. But awesome. You have to take a picture then with me.
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, guys, that's it. Thank you very much.